So, because there is no hardware secure element or module in this hardware, right? The data on it is rather open and public, right? But can you then use a passphrase to encrypt the secret keys, at
Oh
least on the hardware?
it's encrypted. It's encrypted. The passphrase is encrypted. It defaults. You have to use a passphrase. So it is all encrypted. Using your
And
passphrase
so
and
that's a regular, what is it, BIP39 passphrase?
So that's
Cool.
and that doesn't go any doesn't never goes to the it's a hash which is sent. Is it a hash which is sent? It's a hash which is sent at the passphrase. So it's
So
not stored. Go on.
and where do you type it in though?
You type well, this is what you type it. You click it in on your browser, but the so basically the, your browser sends has a keypad with nine buttons, and each button is starred out. So then the buttons are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But they're starred out. Then you look on the device, and there's a scrambled keypad on the device. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, except all the numbers are scrambled. So one might be where nine is, and six might be where seven is, whatever. So you click on the browser your pin, your 8-digit pin. Could be better, but you click on the browser your 8-digit pin, and then it sends an array to the device, the hardware device. Of so it's like okay, he selected number two, he selected number four, he selected number five, and then using the number generated on that, in that array, which it just generates on the fly, isn't stored on the hardware device, it then it says it then is able to take that pin which you've inputted and then take the hash and then use it to restore the thing. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. But I mean,
Okay, but
there would be.
this is a pin that kind of unlocks the hardware, so to say.
It
Okay,
unlocks
but
the you need it also for your it unlocks your private key. So it's your private key is it's using BIP39.